Somebody bless the Lord right in the middle of this situation.
I love your word. I love your spirit and your voice.
Come on and bless the Lord.
Calling my name, oh, he's calling,
calling my name.
to the detail what you desire of him. The Holy Spirit said to me the next 48 hours, he's going to manifest it. He said, tell the people of the Lord to be exact. Because the louder you call him, the greater his promises come. He says, tell him exactly what it is that you desire. And the next 48 hours, he's manifesting it in the lives of those who declare the things before him. Now speak it. It may not even seem possible, but speak it. Say it out of your mouth. Say it out of the heart of God. And watch him perform the word. And as soon as you say it, I want you to praise him right there. Just see it. Come on. My name. Your praise got to be exactly what you're saying. Your worship has to be exactly how you feel. So you declare it. You declare it. That means it has to happen in your life. Calling you. He started wooing you and bringing you into his presence greater. That's why we feel this worship experience happening. And that's why service is so unusual today, because God is now calling you by your name. And Father, release your glory like you always have. Release the promises to your people. Let Judah worship word ministries begin to flourish. Let the prosperity in a recession fall upon this place as they worship you. Thank you for giving. Clap your hands and you can be seated. that a worship, a worship is a warfare worship. That a worship don't even hold you. I need to tell you very softly. I saw this on Friday night. I saw dead chicken heads being cut off. I saw blood sacrifices being made in this region, in this area. I saw literally altars were built to sabotage churches and ministries. There is one great warlock in this area that rules with an iron fist. And God says her worship today is a warfare worship. And it's pulling down strongholds and generational curses that's been released in this region. Not only in this region, it's all in the Miami area. And it's trying to infiltrate all of this area. And God said the greater the worship is, he's going to destroy the hand of the enemy. So I wish there were some worshipers in the house of Judah, because the devil's strongholds are being destroyed. There are literally names on this altar. There are names on this altar. There are all kinds of devices and all kinds of things that they put on the altar to sabotage the house of the Lord. And so when I saw her, and this is how I know, even though I don't know that young man that was standing next to her, but he was trying to compose her. He was trying to set her down. And that's when the Lord said, no, tell them that her worship is a warfare worship. It's a warfare, intercession kind of worship experience. And they're fighting in the heavenlies. There's a fight in the heavenlies going on. There's a fight in the heavenlies going on. There's a fight that's declaring freedom. I feel Jesus, man. Some of you are wondering why you can't get past things. It's because there has literally been curses shouted at you, shouted at your families, generational curses that's been shouted over your lives, and today it is being broken. As a matter of fact, God told me to tell you, many of you, he's sending it back over the waters from where it came. It was released from another place, and God said, I am sending it back from where it came. I am now sending it and crushing the hands and the head of those who are over it. I am tearing down their altar. Prophets are here. Go down to the king to the side. The prophets are here. To holy attention. I take authority to my son. In this region, the prophets are here. Go down to the soul. Romance came. Rande me capelli non solo mosse. Apostolic authority. Be released to the young soul. I feel Jesus. Some of you have been strange, but there's some witnesses here know what I'm talking about.